There's something odd about this birth certificate. Notice that there are no parents listed.
Mm-hmm.
Notice also that it was made out in 1947,
mm-hmm.
which is over a year after your mother was born.
Wow.
According to Andrea's birth certificate, her birth record number was 2221. So we searched the New York City Birth Index again, looking for an entry under the number 2221. And we discovered something that really took us by surprise. We found this entry in the New York City Birth Index for 1946.
Jolly Andra, 1196,
mm-hmm.
certificate number 2221.
There's that number, 2221,
mm-hmm.
and 1196 is your mother's birthday,
mm-hmm.
January 19th, 1946.
Mm-hmm.
That is the actual record of your mother's birth.
That's wild. Andra Jolly?
Your mother was born Andra Jolly. That is your mother's birth name.
Wow.
But how did LL Cool J's mom end up being born Andra Jolly? Where did the name Jolly come from? Based on the DNA results, we had determined that Andrea's father was Nathaniel Christie Lewis. So we had every reason to suspect that Andrea's mother must have been a Jolly. To determine her identity, Cece scoured the databases again, looking for a match with the ancestral surname Jolly. Ultimately, she was able to solve our mystery. LL Cool J's biological grandmother was a woman named Ethel Mae Jolly. And the fact that your mother has a legal birth certificate under the name Andrea Griffith means that she must have been legally adopted by your grandparents. Probably had a baby out of wedlock and put it up for adoption.
So she was legally adopted?
Yep. They adopted and changed her name. And they kept Andra, Andrea.
They just changed it.
They just slightly changed it.
Wow. You know, and I can understand why they didn't tell her. They didn't want her to feel like she didn't belong.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't want us to feel like we didn't belong. I don't know if you call me an adoptee or...
You're the adoptive grandchild. Just think of all the adoptees who will watch.
Yeah. LL Cool J is an adoptee. His mother.
Yeah.
Him and his mom's.
Yeah.
And this doesn't change
mm-hmm.
how I feel about the people that raised me. I respect Eugene Griffith. I respect Ellen Hightower Griffith. They did so well for us. I have more love and respect for them than I ever did. Ever.